Today we will solve a problem from chapter electrochemistry. The problem is a cell is prepared by dipping a copper rod in 1 molar copper sulfate solution and a silver rod in 1 molar silver nitrate solution. The standard reduction potential of copper electrode and silver electrode are 0.34 volt and 0.80 volt respectively. Now first, draw the cell diagram. How will the cell be represented? You have to represent the cell. What will be the cell reaction? Write down the cell reaction. Calculate the standard EMF of the cell and find out the value of standard free energy change for the reaction and predict whether the cell reaction will be feasible or not. Now let us take one by one. First, you have to draw the cell diagram. Now here, the reduction potential of copper electrode is 0.34 volt and silver electrode is 0.80 volt. So, silver electrode will act as a reduction half cell and copper electrode will act as oxidation half cell, because the reduction potential of silver electrode is greater than copper electrode. Now let us draw the cell diagram. Now according to convention, oxidation half cell should be written on left hand side and reduction half cell should be written on right hand side. Now here the electrode, which is made up of copper rod, is dipped in 1 molar aqueous solution of copper sulfate. And here the silver rod or the silver electrode is dipped in silver nitrate solution. This represents the container in which this half cell is formed. Now, this represents the salt bridge. Here, the copper rod act as an anode because oxidation take place in this oxidation half cell, whereas silver rod act as a cathode because the reduction take place in at silver electrode. Here anode is having negative charge and cathode is having a positive charge. This negative charge is developed due to the loss of electron present on this electrode as a result of oxidation of copper atom into copper ion. So this electrode will develop a negative potential as compared to the solution. So this electrode is negatively charged and here the reduction takes place. This electrode will be positively charged because silver ion gains electron from the electrode and it is reduced in the form of silver metal. So this half cell act as a reduction half cell and this half cell act as oxidation half cell. Oxidation half cell should be written on the left hand side and reduction half cell should be written on the right hand side. Here the electron will move from copper electrode towards silver electrode because it is having a negative potential on copper electrode and positive potential on silver electrode. But the movement of the current is opposite to the direction of flow of the electron. Here direct electron is moving from copper electrode towards the silver electrode, but the current direction of the current will be just opposite to the movement of this electron. And this is a salt bridge in which the conductivity is due to the movement of the ions. It is made up of inert electrolyte dissolved in agar-agar and filled in this U-shaped tube, leading to the formation of a semi-solid paste. Now, the salt bridge helps to complete the circuit or to close the circuit, and as well as to maintain the electrical neutrality of the solution present in the two different half cell. Now, this is a cell diagram. So we have to represent the cell diagram by writing oxidation half cell on the left hand side and reduction half cell on the right hand side. Now next, the standard reduction potential given in this question is the half cell potential of copper electrode is equal to 0.34 volt. Here, these copper 2 plus ions separated by copper electrode represents the redox couple. It is the oxidized form of the copper and this one is the reduced form of the copper. They are known as redox couple. This Ag plus ion is the oxidized form and Ag is the reduced form and they are known as redox couple. Now, next part of the question is that you have to represent the cell. For representing the cell, it is according to the convention, we start from the diagram given here. First, we select the copper electrode and separate it by a single vertical line from the solution. This copper electrode and copper 2 plus ions is separated by a single slash vertical line or slash. This represents the oxidation half cell. Now next we come to, first we write the electrode, then the aqueous solution or the electrode which is dipped in its own electrolyte. Electrolyte contains its own ion. Copper is the electrode and the ion present in the electrolyte is copper 2 plus ion. These are the two redox couple. Now next we move to the salt bridge. This salt bridge is represented in the form of double vertical line. This represents the salt bridge. Now after salt bridge, we enter into the aqueous solution. That is nothing but Ag plus ion. So here Ag plus ion is written and the molarity of the solution is given as 1 molar. This Ag plus ion is in contact with silver electrode. Now this electrolyte with containing silver plus ion is separated or is in contact with silver electrode. And the electrolyte and electrode should be separated by a vertical line. So for representing the cell, we move from copper electrode towards the silver electrode in this way. Copper solid in contact with its own ion having concentration 1 mole molar Cu solid slash Cu2 plus ion 1 molar solution. And next we come to the salt bridge which is represented by the double vertical line. Next we come enter into the aqueous solution of silver plus ion, that is Ag plus ion having molarity 1 molar and which is in contact with the silver electrode, that is represented by a single slash and Ag solid. Now electrode in contact with its ion present in the aqueous solution or electrolyte having molarity 1 molar salt bridge, then you have to write down the Ag plus ion or the electrolyte, the respective ion present in the electrolyte in aqueous solution of 1 molar molarity separated by the electrode or slash line and write down the electrode again. We move from oxidation half cell towards the reduction half cell. Copper in contact with copper 2 plus ion separated by salt bridge, silver ion in contact with the silver electrode. Now this is the representation of this cell diagram in short. It is a short representation for a cell. This one is cell diagram, and for representing this cell diagram in the form of short notation, we follow this rule. We represent it from oxidation half cell. This one is oxidation half cell and this one is reduction half cell. Oxidation half cell is represented as electrode in its own electrolyte, present in its own electrolyte having molarity 1 molar. Reduction half cell is represented as electrolyte in contact with its own electrode, electrolyte having 1 molar molar solution and its electrode separated by a single line. This represents the half cell, reduction half cell, and this represents the oxidation half cell, and this is the representation for a salt bridge. Now Next question is, you have to write down this cell reaction. Now this cell is based on a redox reaction where oxidation and reduction reaction takes place simultaneously. As a result of this spontaneous reaction, an electron is being produced, and that move from copper electrode towards the silver electrode because they are not in direct contact with each other. So it will generate a feasible or working cell. Now let us write the cell reaction. This reaction involves two reactions, oxidation and reduction, which goes simultaneously. Copper is being oxidized. Copper loses two electrons to form copper 2 plus ion at anode. And at cathode, the silver ion will accept two electrons, leading to the formation of a silver. The silver ion will accept one electron and it will be converted into Ag. But since here it is loss of two electrons, the electrons should be cancelled during the redox reaction. So we have to balance this equation in such a way to cancel the electron which is generated in case of oxidation reaction. Here it is a loss of electron, that is why it is defined as oxidation. And here silver ion is gaining two electrons, two silver ions, 2 moles of silver ion is giving 2 moles of electron, leading to the formation of 2 moles of silver atoms or solid. This reaction is reduction. It involves gain of electron, that is why it is defined as reduction. And this involves loss of electron, and that is why it is defined as oxidation. Since these two reactions undergo simultaneously, and that is why the overall resultant reaction will be defined as a redox reaction. Here, the two electrons lost in case of oxidation is cancelled by the two electrons gained during the reduction. And so the resultant reaction will be copper solid plus 2 moles of Ag plus aqueous will give copper 2 plus ion in aqueous solution plus 2 moles of silver solid. And this is defined as a redox reaction. Reaction behind this cell, on which this cell is based. Now next part of the question is, find out the standard electrode potential of this cell. Let us find out the standard electrode potential of the cell. Here E0 of the cell is represented as E0 of right minus E0 of left. Here the reduction potential of half cell, which is written on the right hand side, that is silver electrode, and the electrode potential of the electrode, which is written on left hand side, that is nothing but the copper electrode. Let us see the diagram again. From the diagram, this is represented as reduction half cell, and here which is written on right hand side, and this is represented as oxidation half cell, which is represented on the left. Here the standard reduction potential of the silver electrode is given as 0.80 volt, and standard reduction potential of copper electrode is given as 0.34 volt. This is left. Copper electrode is present in left hand side and silver electrode is present on right hand side. The electrode having greater potential should be written on the right hand side. Here the electrode potential of silver electrode is greater than reduction potential of copper electrode. So let us calculate the standard electrode potential of the cell, which is represented as E0 of the cell, will be equal to E0 of right minus E0 of left. Here the E0 of right is nothing but this silver electrode, E0 of silver electrode minus E0 of copper electrode. The value of E0 of silver electrode is equal to 0.80 volt, and the value of half cell potential of standard half cell potential of copper electrode is given as 0.34 volt. By subtracting these values, we get the standard electrode potential of the cell as plus 0.46 volt. Now let us solve the fifth part of this question. We have to calculate The standard gives free energy for the reaction. Calculate the standard gives free energy of the reaction. Here, the standard gives free energy for the reaction is represented as minus NFE0 of the cell. It is dependent on electrode potential, standard electrode potential of the cell, as we have calculated earlier. So here in this formula, N represents the number of electron gain or loss during the redox reaction. F represents the Faraday constant, and E0 of the cell is the standard electrode potential of the cell, which we have calculated earlier. Now, we have to find out the number of electron gain or loss during the redox reaction. We have seen earlier that the redox reaction involves loss and gain of two electrons. So the value of N will be equal to 2. In the resultant redox reaction, we have to take the number of electron gain or loss during the resultant redox reaction, and that comes out to be 2. So N will be equal to 2. And F represents the Faraday constant, which have the value 96487 coulomb per mole. Here it is a Faraday constant, and substituting the value of E0 of cell, as we have calculated here, as 0.46 volt, we get free energy change for the reaction will be equal to minus 2 minus F. And here the sign is taken as negative, minus 2, which is the number of electron gain or loss during the redox reaction, and it is a Faraday constant, 965487 coulomb per mole, multiplied by electrode potential of the standard electrode potential of the cell, that is equal to 0.46 volt. Now solving this, we get minus 88768.04 joules per mole, and converting into kilojoule, we get minus 88.768 kilojoule per mole. Since the free energy change is negative here, we know that free energy change is having the whole soul criteria for predicting whether the change is spontaneous or not, or the reaction is spontaneous or not. So in this problem, the free energy change comes out to be negative, and that is why the reaction will be spontaneous and cell will be fissible. The reaction will be fissible. According to thermodynamics chapter, thermodynamics, we know that the free energy change has whole soul criteria for predicting whether the change will be spontaneous or not. But this free energy change is related or dependent upon this E0 of the cell. If E0 value comes out to be positive, now let us see from here. When E0 cell, that is standard electrode potential of the cell, will be positive, if it will be positive, it will give a negative free energy change value, because it is related with free energy change as minus NFE0 of the cell. If this value is positive, then we will get delta G as negative. But if this value comes out to be negative, then negative multiplied by negative number will give you positive value for free energy change, and in that case the cell reaction will not be visible. So the positive value of electrode potential itself indicates that the reaction will be spontaneous. So we can predict by calculating this electrode potential value of the standard electrode potential value of this cell. If it comes out to be positive, then cell will be visible, and if it comes to be negative, then the cell reaction will not be spontaneous, it will not be feasible. Therefore, for solving such type of questions, we have to follow 6 steps. First, we draw the cell diagram. Second, represent the cell. Write down the cell reaction. Calculate the standard electrode potential of the cell. Find out the standard gives free energy for the reaction. And 6, predict whether the change will be spontaneous or not. थैंक यू।